Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I believe you are together.
Naamini tuko pamoja.
God cannot be God without manifestation.
Mungu hawezi kuwa Mungu bila dhihirisho.
It must manifest.
Lazima ajidhihirishe.
And Moses saw a burning bush.
Moses akaona kichaka kinachoketea.
He was alerted and said, "Let me go and see what's happening in this bush."
Akaenda akasema, "Acha nini kinachoendelea na kichaka hiki."
Because there was fire in the bush, but the bush was not getting consumed.
Kulikuwa na moto kichakani na haikuwa inateketea.
But when he moved closer,
alipokaribia,
he heard a voice.
Akasikia sauti.
Say, "This is a holy ground."
Akasema, "Hapa ni patakatifu."
Remove your sandals.
Vua viatu.
Then he removed the sandals and he moved closer. But the Lord said, "Now listen, I have seen the suffering of my children in the land of Egypt. And I've heard their cry. Hallelujah. I want to send you to rescue them." Emphasis is mine. Emphasis is mine in that statement that I've said. Emphasis.
Kusisitiza ni yangu.
Amen. So God had to manifest to Moses.
Mungu ilibidi adhihirishe kwa Musa.
That Moses would believe
him. Ili Musa aweze kumwamini.
More.
Zaidi.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Even though we need to believe in God, even though we have not seen him, but we see his manifestation.
Hata ingawa yafuate mwili Mungu kabla ya kumwona, yafuate uone mpadirisho.
And God can manifest himself in anything.
Mungu anadhihirisha kwa chochote.
Look at your neighbor.
Mwangalie jirani.
Is made in the likeness of God.
Ameumbwa kwa mfano wa Mungu.
That is God manifested himself.
Hiyo ni Mungu amejidhihirisha.
That is God manifested himself.
Hiyo ni Mungu amejidhihirisha.
That's why the Bible says, "Love your neighbor as you love yourself."
Mpende jirani jinsi unavyojipenda.
How would you say you love God and you do not love your neighbor that you can see?
Biblia inasema wapenda Mungu na mpende jirani ambaye waona.
When the Lord was removing the children of Israel from Egypt, he did a lot of manifestations.
Bwana alipokuwa na Israeli kutoka Misri alitoa madhihirisho mengi.
The children of Israel themselves will believe, and the Egyptian and the Pharaoh will believe even more to let the children of Israel go.
Bwana Israeli waamini na hata Farao aweze kuamini zaidi awachinie wana wa Israeli.
So God also likes to manifest himself.
Mungu pia anapenda kujidhihirisha.
For the benefit of mankind.
Kwa faida ya binadamu.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If God will not manifest himself,
kama Mungu hajidhihirisha,
then he will not relate to mankind. So God manifests himself relates to us also through manifestation.
Basi angeweza kushirikiana binadamu kwa kuwa ili kushirikiana binadamu lazima ajidhihirishe mwenyewe.
And today,
na leo,
as this word of the Lord is coming, this is very prophetic. The blessings of the Lord. If you believe today, you know there is a promise. When you know there is a promise that the Lord has given that belongs to you, is going to manifest in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
One of the promise. The Lord has promised eternal life. That salvation is going to manifest in your life. If you are not born again. If you are sick, I say that healing is going to manifest in your life because it is a promise.
Hallelujah.
Whatever you are trusting God to do, be it an employment, be it a financial breakthrough. Hallelujah. Be it a breakthrough in your marriage. I say today, because God is going to manifest, if you believe, this God is going to manifest in you and you are going to receive. God never does anything without manifesting himself. When it is in relation to mankind, I will take you deeper in this revelation. Hallelujah. First of all, I want to make you understand that there's a lot of things. God has given you everything. These things are in the spirit. And you need to ask God for their manifestation. The book of Ephesians, chapter 1, and verse 3. Ephesians chapter 1 and verse 3. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I want somebody to read it from the seat. Read it, chapter 1 and verse 3. Read aloud.
The Bible says, "Praise be to God and Father our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in the heavenly realms with every spiritual blessing in Christ."
Amen.
Amen. Atukuzwe Mungu Baba wa Bwana wetu Yesu Kristo aliyetubariki kwa baraka zote za rohoni katika ulimwengu wa roho ndani ya Kristo.
I thank God for the inspiration of that word.
Namshukuru Mungu kwa ajili ya ufunuo neno hilo.
It begins by saying praise the Lord.
Inaanza kwa kusema tukuzwe Mungu.
It begins by saying hallelujah.
Inaanza kwa kusema haleluya.
Everyone say hallelujah.
Christ.
And read also this one somewhere.
So,
to expound it to make you understand. From this scripture, he says, praise the Lord, the Father of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Salvation manifests. When you're filled with the Holy Spirit, there's manifestation. Hallelujah. When hallelujah, when Jesus comes, he will manifest to the church and will take the church
home.
So God wants to manifest. But you must know that there's things in the spiritual realm. He has blessed us with. Do you know that first we came from the Spirit? And you made natural? When the Lord said he created them, man and woman. Then we see the actual work of the creation later. When the Lord took humans. And put breath on it. And there was a man. And then a man slept and he took a rib and created a woman. And before, the Lord has said, he created them, man and woman, he created them. It means there is a bit of a light that is spiritual. Why do we have spiritual aspect of our life? The Bible says, for those who are born of God are children of God. Do you get that?
Yes, I know.
So the spiritual bit of you is a man to make you be in contact with the spiritual God. Because God is spirit. So your spiritual power, aspect of your life is to make you relate with the spiritual God. And also to make you able to access things in the spirit. When they manifest in the physical, they help your human nature.
Hallelujah.
Because you see, everyone here in town, you are doing one thing or another. Even if you are at home, there is something that you do that you will eat. From the spiritual things that are manifested. Give Jesus a mighty hand. So the Bible says, He has blessed us with all spiritual blessings. These spiritual blessings will not be able to be beneficial to your natural nature. To your physical nature. Not natural. Physical nature. If it doesn't manifest. If your body is unwell, you need the spiritual healing to manifest in your physical body.
Is it true?
Do you know that when God gave us Jesus? Read Romans 8:32. Just to elaborate something as I continue this
one.
When the Lord gave us Jesus, He gave us all things. When the Bible talks of all things, it including money. Say amen. I'm preaching to a sleeping church.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
He who did not spare his own son, but gave him up for us all.
Yes, amen. He who did not spare his only son, but gave him to us all.
How will he not also, along with him, graciously give us all things?
You get that?
Why do you?
Read this right. Read that last part again.
How will he not also? Along with him.
Along with who? Along with Jesus. Say along with your over. How can you have dominion over? If you're already there. How will you cast out demons if you are dead?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So God has blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly
realms.
These spiritual blessings, for them to be more beneficial to you here, you need to trust God for manifestation. And as we speak now, I see manifestations are beginning to happen in your life. I see manifestations beginning to happen in your life. Whatever you are trusting from the Lord, they are going to manifest. So long as you have Jesus Christ, because in Jesus Christ, we have all things. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I want us to, our eyes, the spiritual eyes be open. Let me tell you. You know what? Open the book of John chapter 1 verse 14. I want to tell you something from there. Amen. I'll tell you something from there. It's a mighty revelation that will change your life forever. John chapter 1 verse 14. Can you read it? But before he reads, the Bible from verse 1 says, in the beginning there was the Word. The Word was with God, and the Word became God. Then verse 14.
Made his dwelling among us.
Read again.
The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us.
The Word became flesh. The Word manifests to the physical that you are able to see and touch and feel.
We have seen His glory, the glory of the one and the only Son who came from the Father, full of grace and truth.
We have seen His glory. The Word became flesh. And therefore we are able to see. Say see.
Never honor.
Say see. There's a song that says that Baba nataka kuona kwa macho, nataka kuona kwa macho, nataka kuona kwa macho, nataka kuona Yahweh, nataka kuona kwa macho,
nataka nione kwa macho,
nataka nione kwa macho,
nataka nione kwa macho.
If you believe, then you shall see. Then you believe, you allow yourself to be a partaker of divine manifestation. But faith becomes prominent, paramount, before it manifests. Because we connect to God by faith. And the Bible describes faith as an evidence of things not seen as though they are. So Jesus,
Yesu,
began in the spirit. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And for us to be saved into a fallen human being, God had to manifest in our form. For us to be saved, to be redeemed, to be restored, to have eternal life, God had to come in a manifest. Spiritual blessings will not be beneficial to you if they are not manifested. But I thank God because you have a spiritual aspect of your life that can go to the spirit and make them manifest. How do you go in the spirit? The Lord said, worship in truth and in spirit. I repeat this one several times. Because I'm not seeing them surveil. I just want to see people, men and women, surveilling. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Until something is born. Do not from your belly there are rivers. The Bible says the rivers of the living waters are flowing from within your belly. Hallelujah. Because rivers give life. Trees that are planted by the riverside, they produce fruit in season and out of season. It means that when you the life of others. You're able to bring forth life, but there's no life. Hallelujah. I'm talking about that on Wednesday. But now I'm talking about Jesus had to be manifest. The Word became flesh. Are you getting this? The Word became flesh. And as I speak right now, this is the words of God. They're manifesting in your life today. Read for me this first book of 1 John chapter
1.
Let me listen to this. John is giving an account of the manifested one, and that is Jesus Christ. And he's giving an account of the physical, the manifested aspect of Christ.
ya Kristo aliyofunuliwa.
Can you read from verse 1?
Somo kwanza mstari wa kwanza.
That which was from the beginning, which we have heard, which we have seen with our eyes, which we have looked at, and our hands have touched.
Just stop there.
Lile tulilokuwako tangu mwanzo, tulilolisikia, tuliloliona kwa macho yetu, tulilolitazama, na mikono yetu ikapapasa.
In the Gospel of John chapter 1 verse 1, he says that there, in the beginning there was the Word.
Yohana mtakatifu sura ya kwanza mstari wa kwanza anasema hapo mwanzo kulikuwako na neno.
But here he says,
hapa anasema,
that which was the beginning.
Lile lilokuwako tangu mwanzo.
Which we have heard.
Tulilolisikia.
Which we have seen with our own eyes.
Tuliloliona kwa macho yetu.
Can you see spirit? How can God be saying God is dwelling among us? There is no manifestation. Church, we need to awake. I said this church, we need to awake.
Every
those who are watching, we need to awake. We need, when God is dwelling with us, His manifestation must be visible. We cannot say God is with us if there is no manifestation for His people. That is it, period. There is no way we say God wants to dwell with us if we don't see manifestation. He said Christ
Emmanuel.
He said God
Mungu
with us. And when he walked on earth, he left a landmark. The Bible says, everywhere he went, he did good. Everywhere he went, he did good. Do you want to hear? I'm asking you, do you want to see God? He will not appear. And he refused to appear even to everyone. Moses. He said, if you see me, you don't leave. But when the Lord opened the eyes of Moses, when he opened his eyes, Moses saw a cloud. Hallelujah. He can manifest in anything. God can manifest in anything. He can manifest in the form of a wind. He can manifest in the form of some of a light. Hallelujah. He can manifest in healing. He can manifest in deliverance. He can manifest in finances for you, believe. I say, God, I manifest for you. Hallelujah. Give Jesus a mighty hand. God loves you. And therefore, he manifests. I like this account. Which we have looked upon. And our hands have touched it. Concerning the word of life. Concerning the word of what?
That
even our hands have touched. I will not say God has given me a wife if I cannot see your touch. The Bible says, a good wife comes from God. How
he
handled from heaven, I don't know. But what I know, he came from God. And I can see her. I can touch her. I can make her wife. I say, you can see. With your eye. And touch. Amen. Say, I want to touch. You know, sometimes you just go before the Lord and just say, you begin to travel. You
meet
before the Lord. And you say, God, it is your promise that when you give me Jesus, I have Jesus in my life. I have everything. I want to see manifestation. And then you begin to travel. You put your hand in your tummy. As a pastor, you don't want to give back. And you say, God, I want to touch. Gold and silver belong to God. It is in the hands of God. In which form? In the spiritual. Will you buy gold in the shop and say, supermarket and say, I've
got
the taskies today, I have the spiritual money. You have done the shopping, don't throw it. Unless you have asked God. Because the Bible says, ask and you shall be given. Until you ask and get it in physical to help you deal with physical things. Then when you have it, then you go there. You have two trolleys for one. Very importantly, whether you have it inside your card or cash, you can stand comfortably.
I can
pick a shovel. That should be my last scripture. Then we pray.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hebrews chapter 2 verse 14. Father, read it.
So
2:14, Mr. Peter.
The Bible says,
yes.
Let the children of flesh and blood, he too shared in their humanity, so that by death he might break the power of him who holds the power of death, that is the devil.
Yes, look at that.
Tell over you.
Inasmuch then as the children have partaken of the flesh and blood, himself likewise shared in the same flesh. Jesus came into our flesh. The flesh that can die, the flesh that has blood and pains, the flesh that can sleep, the flesh that can feel hunger, he came in that form. The flesh that can feel pain, he felt pain, and he cried. He cried on your behalf. He cried on our behalf. Hallelujah. Now we don't need to cry for that pain, but we cry unto God. The Bible says, godly sorrow leads to repentance and to salvation. But the worldly sorrow, that leads to death. You get that? Hallelujah. So he partook of our flesh. And through death, that he may destroy him who had the power of death. And the Bible says that Jesus was manifested to destroy the works of Satan. It means he will not destroy the work of Satan. He did not manifest. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God did not say that the work of Satan will just be die by themselves. You who have Christ in you, Christ living within you, you are the one who stands and says, devil, you know what? Jesus God manifested. He is in me. The greater one in me
than you,
devil. Now I bind you. I bind you. You will not hear Jesus Christ coming to cast out demons. It is He manifested in you. Say it is He manifested in me. The next time Jesus comes, no more work of the ministry. It is ule ule people
will go.
No more prayer. Hallelujah. No more fasting. It will stop there. And even this physical body will be changed to a body that the force of gravity cannot put. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That time, there is no more prayer. If you are not repented before,
you are
destined in somewhere else. For it is written, hallelujah,
hallelujah,
that a man is destined to die
once,
and then the first
sentence.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You cannot repent your sin
when
you are still sin in this body. That you may begin to partake of the manifestation of Christ in this state. It must begin here. A little heaven is here. The kingdom of God is here. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jesus told them that I'm casting out demons. You will know that I'm casting out demons by the finger of God. Because the kingdom of God has come among you. It is the kingdom of God that
you
are operating in. The kingdom of manifestation. Tell your neighbor, God wants to manifest. Stand up on your feet right now. That which you are trusting God for. Even I want to tell you this thing. Even that thing you are not trusting God for. And it is a promise. Begin to trust God for it. It is yours. I say it is yours. That is not getting me. I say it is yours. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It is yours. Begin to trust God for it. Begin to trust God for it. Begin to trust God for it. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Just begin to thank God for Jesus. Begin to thank God for Jesus. Begin to thank God for Jesus. Thank you, Father. Begin to thank God for Jesus today, this morning. Begin to thank God for Jesus. In Him there is manifestation for everything. I say in Him there is manifestation for everything. For Him there is manifestation for everything. Thank you, Jesus. Begin to trust God. Open His word. Thank you, Jesus. Please. Begin to trust God. Begin to trust God. Don't worry. The Spirit of God is already doing something. He's already doing something. I can see. He's already doing something. The Spirit of God is already doing something. The Spirit of God is already doing something. Prayer. God is going to manifest Himself in this place in an amazing and wonderful way you've never seen before. I assure you, Jesus is alive and He's here. Jesus is alive and He's here right now. Jesus is alive and He's here. Jesus is alive and He's here. Begin to believe, begin to just see what the Lord has promised you. Whatever it is that you desire. So long as you have Jesus Christ, the Bible says that the Lord shall grant the desires of your heart, those who delight in Him. Are you delighting in Jesus? Begin to receive right now. Begin to receive right now. Are you delighting in the Lord? Begin to receive. Begin to receive. Begin to receive. Begin to receive right now. I want to hear people pray right now. Prayer, 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 prayer. Prayer, 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 prayer. Prayer, 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 prayer. Prayer, 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 prayer. Prayer, 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 including the prayer of repentance. Just go to God and tell God, I'm a sinner, have mercy upon me. I want to partake of your promise, but I'm not in this state of sinfulness. I cannot be able to read them. Just the promise in the Spirit, in the name of Jesus, have mercy upon me. And then after that, you begin to access. Begin to access. Say, my Father, my Father, I come before you with my spirit being, go into the spiritual realm. to the invisible. Oh my Father, I pray, I want to be a partaker of the divine nature. In the name of Jesus Christ. Lord Almighty, remember me. Remember me. Tell God to remember you right now. Prayer. God, remember me. God, remember me. Remember me today. Remember me, Father. Remember me. Remember me, my God. I come before you and I pray, Jehovah. Remember me, Father. Remember me. In the name of Jesus. Remember me.
Father, I pray for the mighty manifestation right now. Save fire! Save fire! Save fire! Save fire! Save fire!
something that God cannot do.
Amen.
God is manifesting now. Then I'm just Christ. Lift up your head. God is manifesting right now. In the name of Jesus. Brother, no more delay. Stand up. No more delay. See, no more delay. Receive right now. The touch of God in the name of this guy. No more delay. This time, come here. Thank you, Jesus. Follow very fast. Thank you, Jesus. Lift up right there. Lift up your head.
You know me, fool.
But this boy, like, is not needed where you're married. I'm saying, a boy that looks like yours, you gave birth to this boy. You have a baby, son. You have sons, but I'm talking about the first one. Where is he right now? He's in your church. What is the relationship between him and the father? Is the father around? Relationship? Why do you think the relationship is not good? That is what I'm saying.
She came out the first out of heaven. Have I seen you before? Were you here yesterday on Friday? Is this the first time you are here?
Fire of the Holy Ghost is going to restore that hope right now. Whatever it is going to be away right now. Come here, look at me. Stand there. Look at me. The eyes, the Lord has put fire in. In the name of Jesus Christ. Come here. There is nothing that the Lord is going to do for you here. I promise the Lord is going to do anything you trust him to do.
Increase of salary.
Yes. Yes.
If you do this week, then how happened? How it Come on. Thank you. Oh, yeah.